Hello friends, today in an exclusive interview, I am right now sitting in the office of Thiagarajar Mills Private Limited, a giant in South India, Madurai, Tamil Nadu, to be precise. I am sitting with Mr. Hari Thiagarajar, who is the executive director of this company, this group. Shall we begin, Mr. Hari? Good morning to you. Mr. Hari, the first question which obviously comes to the mind is, how was the current cotton season 2013-14 in general for the Indian spinning mills?
In the current cotton season, overall has been good for us, considering that the prices have dropped significantly from the last year. So it has been a good place to buy. But the problem was in terms of quality of cotton. There were some hitches in terms of micronair or the staple length. And only when the cotton came into the mills, we saw that there was a 1 mm to 1.5 mm difference in staple length or micronair. Right. And I think overall the crop size also is estimated to be around 400 lakh bales, which I think is a record high.
Right.
And I think we should really commend our farmers and ginners, because they have really gone into modernizing, and there's a lot of reports about cotton being called the white gold.
How do you normally judge the market, Mr. Hari? How do you normally judge the market trend during the cotton season?
Market trend, we usually, when you're in the market, you know how the supply and demand is. So it is usually we see how the yarn movement is, how the fabric movement is.
Right.
And we are also into fabrics. So depending on the fabric, we also try to guess how the yarn scenario will be for that particular quarter or for that particular year. And we also mostly go by reports which we get from our agents and other suppliers.
Right.
So mostly the market is judged by the buyers, I think.
It is your buyers and the reports that you receive from the
suppliers.
You analyze both ways. Just to add that,
and since we are also in the home textiles market,
right,
one of our companies, which is the weaving unit,
right,
40% of our yarn, which is produced in Thiagarajar Mills, is supplied to our sister concern called BTM.
What is your idea about the trend in the new season, Mr. Hari?
New season, I think we have almost reached the bottom line in terms of prices.
Right.
Though some people think there might be another 1000 to 2000 rupee drop in prices, but I think today it is a buyer's market.
Absolutely.
I think the buyer can absolutely demand
take
for
it,
whatever price he wants, so it is very easy to negotiate with the sellers of cotton here in India.
Right.
And I think it's an absolutely buyer's market, and I also think it will tend to continue to be the same way
throughout the season.
Yeah, throughout the season, or at least in the first half of the season,
right,
we will see that there will be a strong, it will be a strong buyer's market.
Right.
Because there are cotton stocks lying around everywhere, and
right,
as you know, the exports to China have also come down in the recent past.
Yes.
And I think China is also holding on to huge reserves, which they'll start letting into their own market soon.
Right.
So a lot of cotton, which I think was going into China, will get cut down. So that I think will add on to the stock piles here in India at the moment.
Regarding the cotton crop, like, whom do you rely on for the estimate of the crop for the season? There are so many agencies. We have Agriculture Ministry, the Cotton Association of India, the CAB, the CCI, then the ICAC and the USDA are the international agencies. So whom do you rely on for the correct estimate?
I think the Indian crop size is always debatable. Each one comes up with one figure, so the closing stock figure is never the same.
Right.
So each one, each of these organizations have a particular figure. But over the years, out of our own experience of studying reports, of studying the cotton balance sheets every year,
right,
we see that the USDA and the CAB reports are quite consistent.
Okay.
And the USDA and the CAB numbers tend to correlate much better
to the practical situation.
To the practical situation.
Okay.
So we usually go with the USDA reports and the CAB reports.
Okay.
Though I am not saying that the other figures can be absolutely wrong or tangentially wrong.
Right.
These two tend to be a little more
realistic.
Realistic.
the most important question, sir, is currently there seems to be a loss of trust in the market between ginners and mills, or say ginners and exporters. You being a spinning mill, you are exporter of yarn and garments. How do you safeguard your company in this situation?
See, as I told you, the raw material, you know, plays a very important role in our market.
Right.
Because even the slightest of contamination or the slightest of poor parameters will tend to affect our yarn quality and
right.
also, you know, show up in the fabric quality.
At a much higher
And these days, our buyers tend to focus a lot on parameters like last-minute falls. Like last-minute falls and nets also. So we need to be very particular on the kind of cotton that we choose. So we stick to a basic set of approved sellers to us.
Right.
And we normally don't tend to go outside that list.
Okay.
Though sometimes prices of other ginners might be a little more attractive. Or prices of the other shippers can at times be attractive.
Right.
We tend to stick with our approved list of suppliers. So that we know that the quality is guaranteed and we don't have to take a bet on in terms of quality.
Mr. Hari said that when their buyers buy from some reputed concern like the Thiagarajar mills, it is taken for granted that the quality will be such.
Right.
And it is committed in the contract. So any deviation from that can cause losses to the buyers and ultimately you may lose that buyer. So to avoid that, they have already installed the best of machines. They already have the best of people working for them. The only thing that has to be done on a day-to-day basis is have a select set of suppliers. So I think it is the right system that you've chosen to stick with tried and tested people. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.